Nigeria was counting ballots on Sunday, a day after a historically tight presidential election that has energized Africa's most populous nation, where many long for change. The vote was mostly peaceful, despite some cases of violence, delays and technical glitches, and citizens stayed up late at night in many locations to observe the count and protect the ballots.
Yesterday, election was very okay. It was free and fair because nobody fought there. Everything was just moving accordingly.
The slow uploading of results online was starting to stir up fears of electoral malpractice in a country with a history of vote rigging. Nearly 90 million voters were eligible to vote on Saturday for a successor to President Muhammadu Buhari, who is stepping down after two terms marked by worsening security and growing poverty.
Let them do the right thing. Though I cannot trust all of them, I can't trust them 100%, but we are appealing that they should do the needful so that the interests of voters or electorates will be taken care of. Our interest is to have a good system where everybody will be carried along.
The election pits former Lagos Governor Bola Tinubu, 70, of the ruling All Progressives Congress, APC, against an old rival, former Vice President Atiku Abubakar of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, 76 years. But for the first time since the end of military rule in 1999, a third-party candidate, Peter Obi of the Labour Party, has challenged the APC and PDP dominance with a campaign message of change.
I'm expecting that there will be a positive change. No matter how it is, no matter how difficult it is now, my hope is that there will be a positive change. That's all.
That everything will change. Everything will change. Nigeria will become a better place. And our kids, our children, they will have a better tomorrow.
Spread over more than 176,000 polling units, voters also cast their ballot for Nigeria's two houses of parliament, the National Assembly and Senate. In Lagos and other cities, crowds stormed polling stations late on Saturday as electoral officials tallied the first results by hand and read out the counts before transmitting them to a central database.
So the populace, we have a change idea. A lot of crime in the system because of hardship. Look at now, we don't have any money. I don't know why they muddled up things. This time, election is coming. Financial crunch. Nothing is working. People are suffering. Yet, they insisted because they want a new Nigeria. Some did not eat anything, but they stay calm.
On Sunday morning, people gathered at a newspaper stand in the Falomo area of Lagos, eager for results to come in.
Tell you exactly now that INEC will give us free and fair. Because what we have here may be changed somewhere. And they will say it is free and fair.
In the southern oil hub of Port Harcourt, a dozen people were still at their polling station unit after the counting had finished on Saturday, shouting at the electoral official to destroy unused ballots. Nearby at Rumo Pircom Civic Center, where electoral staff from 78 polling units were gathered to upload results online, frustrations were growing. As of Sunday morning, results from the presidential election were not yet available on the website of the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC. Despite the isolated cases of violence and technical problems, INEC remained confident about the electoral process. The competitive race has some analysts forecasting an unprecedented runoff between the two frontrunners if no candidate meets election requirements. It would have to be organized within 21 days.